made, so that is unto that Rudraya. That is, Oshadinam Pataye Rudraya Namaha. Other way of looking at it is, the master of the herb is Soma. Soma is Chandra Moon. Moon gives the nutrition, nourishment to the herb. That is why moonlight also is necessary. I don't know present day practice, olden days before sowing the paddy or such grain, for 15 days they used to expose to moonlight. That means the grains which are going to be sown used to absorb the nutrition from moonlight. So somaha rasatmakaha, somo bhutva rasatmakaha, Bhagavad Gita, rasasvarupa, that nutrition that comes from nourishment comes from moon. So that is one way, soma swarupa, and in the form of soma, the one chandra, one who protects the herb, and to that Rudra, our salutation. Continuing.
Nama krujjai bhutaya krandayate.
उच्चैः घोषाय नमः आक्रंदयते नमः पत्तीनां पतये एवरीवेयर रुद्राय 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 नमः सल्यूटेशन टू दैट रुद्र हु इज उच्चैः घोषः वन हु हैज गॉट लाउड रोरिंग वॉइस सी इन ओल्डन डेज दैट इज big sound was being made, like a roaring sound, like lion's roar. Even Bhishma did it before blowing the conch. It is just to, that is, challenge the enemies. And louder the voice, more fright is there, fear is there. Oh, this person is like this. So, Uchyair Ghoshaya. In fact, in olden days, nowadays loudspeakers are there, no problem. Even if the fellow talks, it can be increased. Olden days, speakers used to develop their voice. Do you know how? They used to go to beach. and shout loudly. You know why they should? They have to overcome the noise of the waves. Overcome the noise, they should hear themselves. So by that slowly they used to see. It happens when you are speaking, if around noise is there, automatically your voice goes up. That's why I don't go anywhere to give any talk, etc. where road traffic is there. In fact, it used to happen here. This Anandashram anniversary, they used to invite me ground floor, and the heavy traffic there, even loudspeaker, and the big pedestal fans roaring, etc. Automatically voice goes up and then I suffer after. So they used to practice that Uchchaya Ghosha by practice. By practice they used to go. So that is Uchchaya, the one who has got such a loud roaring voice at the time of the war, etc. Unto that, my namaskara. In fact, when Hanuman entered the Lanka, when he was burning the Lanka, he roared in such a way, so all got frightened, even the Rakshasis who were pregnant aborted. They aborted. Such a fear. So that is what it is. So that is how it is. Hanuman start rolling, what will happen? In fact, it happened. See, Ravana got the news that who has come? Rama has come with the army of monkeys. He consulted the minister. Minister said, what a great deal is that? Monkeys are our food. We need them and finish. Ah, yes, yes. They all said that way. Then Indrajit got up. Where were all these brave warriors when one monkey entered the Lanka? And he spoke a little disparagingly. So they got annoyed. Only because you are the son of the king. I said, I am not telling, I am telling the truth. Were you not hungry at that time? when one monkey entered, were you not hungry at that time? So that is what Hanuman was. So rose. Uchair Ghoshaya. Uchair Ghoshaya. So that shows the strength. Who can shout loudly? One who has got that much of strength. Say, unto that Rudra, my Namaskara. Akrandayate. So one who makes the enemies weep by challenging them. Akrandayan. So that is making them weep or cry, or one who challenges the enemy. Akrandayate Rudraya Namaha Astu. Unto that my Namaskara. Or one who makes all enemies weep. That is what means when it is happened. Yuddheshu Jayakarinah. So the one who is certain of victory in the battle only can make the enemies weep. Now, Patti Naam Pataye Rudraya Namah. Patti is foot soldier. Foot soldiers are called Patti. Others also are Patti. You see the other meaning also. Foot soldier. One who is the master of the foot soldier. So those means they are not riding on the horse or chariot or elephant, etc. So who are the foot soldiers and their master, unto them I namaskar. Or Patti means one army, small army unit. Like regiments also, regiments are big. But small army unit is called Patti. So what is that? It consists of Ekaha Ratha. So one chariot. Then Gajaha Cha Ekaha. So the one elephant. Naraha Pancha Padatayaha. 5 foot soldiers. Trayascha Suragaha. And 3 horses. This unit is called Tadnehi Patihi Aiti Abhidiyate. This unit, a small unit of army, is called as Patti. So the one Patti Naam Pataye, either way, one is the master of either foot soldiers or an army unit called as Patti. Continuing.
Nama Krishna Vitaya Dhavate.
Nama Krishna Vitaya Dhavate.
कृष्णवीताय रुद्राय नमः धावते रुद्राय नमः सत्वनामपतये रुद्राय नमः आई एम रिपीटिंग रुद्राय सो दैट इट शुड इम्प्रिंट इन योर माइंड रुद्र 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 एंड नॉट जस्ट वर्ड मीनिंग रुद्र विद कृष्णवीता कृष्णवीता मीन कृष्णम सैन्यम वीतम वेष्टितम येन One who encircles the entire enemy's army. Means what? They are trapped. When the entire enemy army is encircled, they are trapped. So that is how it is. That is what happened in Bangladesh war. You know? Bangladesh war, after victory, army chief took the, what is that? That is what? The account of it, what has happened, and they were alarmed that The death of army officers was about 60 to 70%, which is very bad for an army. 60 to 70% of the army officers died. They said there is something wrong in the battalion, something they investigated. Then they found there was no reason to be afraid as such. There was a reason to be proud of. What happened was, I don't know the name of some Maharashtrian only. He with his elite parachute planted in between the two armies. Means what? Bangladesh army is near the Indian district. They somehow went through and stood in between the two armies. What happened? The army unit which is the Indian border was separated from the country. And then one after the other, they all army officers were vying with each other and they were on the forefront. And then what they do? Soldiers are sent on the forefront, they are at the back, they are on the forefront, and when the soldiers say, and many mortality were there, etc. But within no time, they won the battle. That is their aspect. So encircling, because this unit was totally separated from the mother country as such. They can't fight for a long time. So that is how it is. So one encircles the army, army of the enemies, Krishna Bhitaya, unto them. Dhavate, one who runs, not running from the battlefront, running after those who run. Enemies who runs after them. So that is the enemies who run. You know, Krishna ran from battlefront 18 times. And he is called Ranchod. See, I just got a big name, Ranchod. If somebody has said, are you Darpok? Darpok. If Krishna runs away, they call Ranchod. See, how an avatar functions does is beyond the imagination of anyone. There was a purpose. Actually, he ran away from Jarasandha's army. Jarasandha was not even a mosquito for Krishna. So he was not safe. And why he was running? Number one, as per the Daiva, Jarasandha's death is in the hands of Bhima. So Bhima only has to kill him. Krishna can't kill him. Number two, Jarasandha's power was too much for Bhima. It was too much for Bhima. And he knew finally a duet will be there and Jarasandha can overcome. So what Krishna used to do? He used to fight in such a way, he used to slaughter all the army of Jarasandha. There was a purpose in that also. Again, why 18 times? 18 times Jarasandha attack and you see. All the bad elements, Rakshasi Pravritti people used to polarize in Jarasandha's army. One of them was Ekalavya. And these bad elements from all over India, Krishna wanted to finish them before he leaves the body. If he was to kill them, he has to travel on the tour of India to kill these people. So at one place, getting polarized in Krishna, Jarasandha's army, he used to kill. That was another purpose, second purpose. Third one, afterwards he used to run. Jarasandha used to chase him. And Krishna used to run in such a way, he used to come very close to Jarasandha. And Jarasandha, abhi beta kidhar bhagega, abhi isko pakda karke. And he used to give the slip. Jarasandha used to get so angry, that was the purpose. By anger, one's strength gets depleted. So he used to deplete his power by making angry. Every step he used to make like that. He used to come close and slip away. Come close, slip away. So that is not there. So three reasons were there. There was no other way why Krishna should run away from him. So what that is? So that is all. So one who is, so dhavate, not one who runs away from the battlefront, so one who chases all those who run away from the battlefront. And to that Rudra, my namaskara, or the dhavata sattva, dhavate, sattvanam pataye namaha. Sattvanaha means sattvikaha. Those who surrender to Rudra, the one who protects those who have surrendered to him. Skanda Bhashya gives us other meaning. Sattvanampati, the one who bhaktam shodayati. Bhaktam shodayati means either purifies the devotee or tests the devotee. Acha, Bhagavan also tests here to give promotion. So Bhagavan also tests to give promotion. So that is that. But that test is out of love. So the message says, bhaktam shodayati, prasidati, blesses. So, punaha tasmai cha sigram sada, vatsam gohe goho iva cha anudhavati. Always runs after them, like the mother cow runs after the calf to protect them. So, again, one who leads one's devotees and the jnanis, and to that sattvanam, bhaktanam, sharanagatanam, palakaya, protector, my namaskara. With this, the second anuvaka is over. Again, in third anuvaka, up to 8 mantra, Rudra Bhagavan is saluted as Sarveshwara, master of everything. Sarveshwara, he is being saluted. Continue.
Namaskara manaya nivyadina.
Namaskara manaya nivyadina.
Yadini nam pataye namaha.
Yadini nam pataye namaha.
Sahamanaya namaha. Nivyadine namaha. Avyadhini nam pataye namaha. Sahamanaya, the one who not only bears the thrust of army's attack, enemy's attack, but what is that? The one who overpowers. The two things are there. One should bear the thrust of enemy's attack first, and then overpower. One who does both. So, one who overpowers so the entire enemy by bearing their thrust. Or, other meaning is, one who forgives the mistakes of devotee. Bhaktaparadhan kshamamanaya. So, one who forgives the wrong deeds of the devotee unto them. Nivyadhine. So, those who totally oppose him, unto such people, what? He pierces. Pierces means he totally destroys them. He is one who totally destroys those who opposes him. So, Nivyadhine. Nivyadine Namaha. Then Avyadhinaha Avyadhini Nam Pataye Namaha. A means Samanta on all sides. A means Samanta on all sides. One who pierces the enemy from all sides means brave warrior. One who pierces the enemies from all sides means the brave warrior. One who is Rudra, one who is the protector of all the brave warriors. That is what Avyadhini Nam Pataye Namaha. Avyadhini Nam Pataye Namaha. And to that, Rudra Panchvasi. Sahamanaya Rudraya Namaha. Divyadhini Rudraya Namaha. Avyadhini Nam Pataye Rudraya Namaha. Now, continue. Kakubhaya Rudraya Namaha. Nishangine Rudraya Namaha. Tenanam Pataye Rudraya Namaha. Rudra, who is Kakubha. Kakubha means Kakubha Sadrishaha. Kakubha means one who is distinguished, superior. Kakubha. So that means Pradhana Bhutaya, one who is the preeminent, and to that Rudra, my Namaskara. Nishangi is Khadgahasta, one who has got sword in the hand, and to that Rudra, my Namaskara. Kakuba also means Kakudi Bhati iti Kakubhaha. So, kakudi is hump of a bull, you know, that which can be seen even from the distance. That's how a bull can be distinguished, because of the hump. Cow don't have that much of hump. So, therefore, say, the hump of a bull. And who is this bull? Nandi. So, one who is what? That means shine on the hump or the back of the bull, Kakubha. Shiva, that way Rudra, so Rudra, so that way Kakubhaya Namaha. Nishangine, again, the one who strikes the enemy with the sword. Tenanam Pataye Namaha. Now problem comes. Tenanam Pataye Rudra Namaha. Our salutations unto Rudra, who is the either protector of thieves or the one who is chief of thieves. First let us see who is Tena. See, among thieves and cheats, varieties are, you come to know this word. We just say thief or the chief, we say. But there are varieties depending on what way of thieving is there. See? Gupta Choraha Stenaha. Gupta Choraha means unknown thieves. They commit the theft without knowing. Gupta Choraha. See, there are others. Openly attack and rob. They are not Stenaha. So they will come afterward. So this, that is quietly, without anybody's notice. So, like that. So when all have gone for a vacation outside, flat is locked. That flat is empty afterwards. Nobody knows. So who has stolen the goods? So that was it. So Senanam Pataye Namaha. Otherwise, this is Rudraha hi Leelaya Nataha eva Tattadvesham Dhatte. Rudra, out of sport, takes different forms, including Stena. Achha, then why does it tell in the Shastra one should not thieve, theft should not be committed? We'll come to this. This is from the standpoint that there is nothing other than Parameshwara Tattva Rudra. Everything. Stena, who thief, has got two aspects. One, the criminal aspect of committing the theft. That belongs to the jiva, individual jiva who is a thief. Other aspect is Antaryami Parameshwara. What is the true nature of the thief? Antaryami Parameshwara. So, Vachyartha is thief, Lakshyartha is Parameshwara. So, Vachyartha theft is prohibited by who? Shastra. Why? If you commit the sin, your card is going to get punched. Papa incurs and that individual has to suffer, pay for it in future. See, one should not commit sins. Why for? What for? From one's own good. Otherwise, you have to pay in terms of sorrow. So that is it. So that is as per Jiva Prohibition Shastra. But Ishvara Sarva Bhutana Hriddeshe Arjuna Tishtati. So Ishvara, as a Sarvantaryami, abides in the Hridaya of everyone. That enables everyone to function. Then he should be held responsible, no? You know that, I think you must be knowing this story, it's a very common story. See, one farmer, rich farmer was there, and he had got gardens and all that with fruits and fodder for vegetation and all. One cow entered the garden and ate of it. He got so angry and he bit it, the cow died. Go hatya pataka. Yamaraja came. When he died, so go hatya yodha. He said, no, not me. How come? Hand did it. And Adhishtan Devata of hand is Indra. Adhishtan Devata of hand is who? Indra. Indra committed. Achcha. Oh. I didn't know that. Okay. He disappeared. And came in the disguise of an old Brahmin and entered his house. Whose farm is this? Whom does this belong, the gardens belong? The farmer can maybe. Oh, how beautifully, nicely you have cultivated, right? See? Yes, yes, yes. I took so much of pain, etc., etc. Achha, you cultivated all these things, such rare varieties of fruits, etc. Yes, 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 I took, etc., etc. How did you do that? Hand! Achha, Yamaraja revealed, when you killed the cow, Indra is responsible, and now I did it, come on. Now, come on. ये होशियारी नहीं चलती है ना दिस होशियारी डज टू वर्क विथ भगवान एस बेस्ट बी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड इफ स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड देर सम सॉलिस इज देर सम कंसेशन इज नथी इफ ए क्रिमिनल इन द प्रिजन बिहेव प्रॉपरली सम कंसेशन इज गिवन सो देयरफॉर बी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड भगवान में गिव समय में ही मे बिस्टो सम ग्रेस. So that is it. So that is Tenana. So these are the two aspects. So that is how it is. So Here, let us see what Sayana has to say, because this is a very important topic. Now, one after another, all criminals, murderers, all here, and presented as Rudra. So that means, we have seen Brahma Sutra to this effect in the introduction itself as such. So, everything is Parameshwara, Sarupa, only that Asarvantaryami, Sarupa. But this division, Dharma, Adharma is given, so that first you get rid of Dharma, get rid of Adharma, and cultivate Dharma, and then rise above both Dharma and Adharma, you discover your Swarupa. So that way it is to be taken to. So first Dharma is indispensable. If Dharma is not followed, you can see what is happening around today. Today what is happening not only in India, but all over the world, because of Adharma is rampant. See, those who are supposed to administer the country, those who are supposed to give take care of the judiciary, they themselves are what? Interfering and saying, so what is going to happen? Dharma rakshati rakshita. If you protect the dharma, that's it. So, dharma hataha hanti. If you destroy dharma, means if you don't abide by dharma, that adharma will perish you, will destroy you. There is no escape from adharma at all. Only thing is the matter of time. Is the matter of time. It takes its own time to fructify yourself. So that is said. So now, I will just go through Sayana Bhashya. Tasya means Rudrasya. Sarva Jagadatma Katva. Being the Swarupa of entire Jagat. Ye Yatra Yatha Vartante. Whosoever the person may be, wherever they are, tatra tatharupena rudraha vartate. Rudra is there in whatsoever form, there is the individual means, there is no one other than Rudra. Iti rudraste sarvatmyam. Sarvatmyam means sarvasvarupam. Anusandhatum means chintayitum, to think of sarvatmya, of Rudra, that Rudra is everything. So, mantraihi evam uchyate. By this mantra, now that are coming one after that, it is said so. Tenadi sharireshu, in the embodiment of the thieves, murderers, etc., Rudraha Vedha Vartate. Rudra is in twofold ways. What are those? Jiva Rupena, Ishvara Rupena. One in the form of Jiva, other in the form of Ishvara. Tatra cha, among these two, yas Jiva Rupam, tat stenadi shabdanam vachyaha artha. The Jiva meaning is what? Turned by what? The thief, murderer, etc. These words, that is the immediate meaning of the stena, chochora, all these things. Sahaiva, that aspect of theft, etc., shastreshu nindya, is something censured where in the shastra. Yattu ishvara rupam, tat stena di shabdaihi upalakshate. Whereas the ansarvantaryami, Ishvara Swarupa, is implied in the word thief. Not the direct meaning of word thief, but is implied in the meaning of thief. So, tadanu sandhanam, if you do the chintana of the Ishvara aspect in the thief, it says, pabakshaya hetutvena paramapurushartha. It is a means to gain the ultimate purushartha moksha by destroying the papa. So, that is the case here. Both now, sarvantaryami, all may not be able to appreciate. So, therefore, vachyartha immediately has to say, oh, thief. So, thief is given, to point out that Antaryami in Ishvara is Rudra only. Continuing.
Namo Nishangira Kishu Dhimate.
Namo Nishangira Kishu Dhimate.
Tatkara.
Nishanga, the earlier also Nishangi has come, Khadgastha, Khadgastaha. So then now again the word has come. One same meaning can be taken, other Nishanga means the arrow which is held in the hand to what? Load on the bow. Means it is not yet struck to the bow, but it is held in the hand, means arrow kept ready to strike. So that is what Nishangaha. So the one who has got Nishanga, one who holds the arrow in the hand to strike. And Ishudhi is quiver. We have seen this earlier also. Banadharaha quiver. So one who is the one who holds the arrow to strike in the hand, one who has got the quiver on the back. Other meaning of Nishangi can be one who is always attached to the devotees. Bhakteshu nirantaram saktimate. One who is always attached to the devotees. Means one who is ready to do anything for the devotees. So, Ishudhimate, already we have seen earlier also this word has come. Namo Nishangine Ishudhimate Namaha. Nishangine Nama Rudraya Namaha. Ishudhimate Rudraya Namaha. Now, Taskaranam Pataye Rudraya Namaha. Taskara. Now see, Stena was there. Stena are thieves who come in a hiding manner, unknownly. Taskaras are who rob openly. They come in front of you and robbery. So who openly rob, so they are called taskara, prakata chora. So they come in front of you, no hiding, nothing doing. So that is that. Also they say, come on, what all things are there? If you say no, don't tell a lie. that thief expects you to tell the truth. See how dumb he is. He expects you to tell, don't tell a lie. Where is the key of the cupboard? Don't tell the lie. So then Taskara openly who rob unto them. So unto that is pratyaksham haranti where vanadishu tishthantaha. They plant themselves in forest, etc., where others are not there, and you are alone, they catch you. So that is catch you. One thing, this taskara, there are varieties. Other fellows, they will rob and kill also. This fellow is not that variety. That variety is coming. Not only openly will rob and finish the fellow and then go. See, at least it happened in the case of who? Jaya Govinda. He had gone to some king. He was a Virakta. And king was very much pleased with his Devadatta. He said he gave 2 diamonds. Then what is the use of them? Anyway, out of love I have given and very precious diamond. And he kept and was going. 2 thieves caught him. They were, if you want, you take it. It has no value for me. He gave, but on the height of it, they cut his hand. He cut his hand. But Jai Govinda had no grudge against those things. He was healed, etc. So king came to know. He was, I think, performing some yaga, etc. So Jai Govinda was invited, etc. And all mini sadhus were invited. And all huts were made, separate huts for separate sadhus, etc. So Jai Govinda also was. Jai Govinda has devotion for sadhus. He said, King, he was special consideration for Jai Govinda. And who? King was apologetic as such. So that is it. He said, King, I would like to have darshan of all the sadhus. So king himself came and took one by one. In one kutiya, he saw that same two things. He didn't say anything. He did namaskara to them. And afterwards he told king, see, those two sadhus are special sadhus. Call them and honor them. Honor them. So honor them. Of course, Jai Govinda has said, King is there, and he was there, and king gave them wealth profusely. And while going, he said, some robbers may take away for each one guard he gave. Two guards went to escort them, etc., because they have to go with them. These guards were surprised. Why? Because they know the stature of Jai Govinda. Why such a great Mahatma should have such affinity toward these two special sadhus? They, while going, they asked, Maharaj, you know Govinda, Jai Govinda? ये तो बच्चा था, हमारे पास बहुत दबे आता था वो, अभी बड़ा हो गया है. Jai Govinda went to his sadhu trait and they went to through his all criminal traits, etc. So that they were boasting like that, etc. But Jai Govinda, then Krishna revealed and he got the hands back. Jai Govinda got the hands back, etc. So there are varieties of sadhu. Poor fellow, he gave the diamonds but they cut his hand. So now these taskaras, they don't kill, but they openly rob. Taskaradham palakaya rudraya namaha. Continue.
Namo vanchati parivanchati.
Namo vanchati parivanchati.
Ta yunam pataye namaha.
Ta
वंचते रुद्राय नमः परिवंचते रुद्राय नमः स्थायूनां पतये रुद्राय नमः. ऑल आर चीट्स ओनली बट थ्री वैरायटीज ऑफ चीट्स. वंचते वन द वन पर्सन हु विन्स द कॉन्फिडेंस ऑफ द मास्टर as a very obedient and what? Service-minded servant. And then what he do? He waits for an opportunity and then cheats him. Swaminaha aptaha bhutva. Swami here with master. Being a very close associate of the master. So, in the dealing of purchase, selling, etc. Because his property is there. See, he sells, he purchases there. There is a cut. Vanchana, cheating. Vanchana is cheating. So there is cheating. So that is, as and when occasion comes, he cheats. The thief has got to be. So, parivanchana, vanchana, depending on the occasion. Not all cases, but where the cut is more, he does it. Parivanchana, invariably, in all the dealings, one who cheats. Parivanchana. Sarveshu api vyavahareshu apannavaha parivanchana. In all the vyavahara, the one who, I heard in olden days, one just story like this generation. A servant was there, and the master knew that any purchase, etc., etc., he does cheat. He knew, the master knew. What is master thought one day? Let me see. Those days, dabri, you know, dabri is where that. He sent him to bring something which cost one dabri, and he gave him one dabri. One dabri was. He purchased and brought and gave it. Triumphantly, the master said, "What did you take today? You can't get anything." That fellow was on Ekvadisma. See, this is what I was saying. I have rubbed it and they made a paste of it, little I had already. That grinding stone, no? See, like chandan, etc. I have already rubbed it. You see, this is what I have already taken. Parivanchate. Will not leave even a single occasion without cheating. So parivanchate. Now stayu. Says tena and stayu. So we have already tena nam pataye has come. So we already seen. Tena means unknown thief. So, this Sayana Bhashya gives two varieties of choraha. Gupta choraha dvividhaha. Gupta choraha, unknown thieves are two types. Who are those? Duran agastya ratrahu. Having come from far in the night, agatya ratra, adnyataha santaha, unknown, is incognito, kapatodghatanena, break the almira, kapatodghati. In olden days also it was that, don't think only modern days, kapatodghatina, dravyapahartara, who rob away whatever gold, etc., ornaments, etc., they are stena. Now, these are more dangerous than the stayus. Who are stayus? Svakiya eva bhutva. They become your own person. Like a friend or a servant, etc. They win over the confidence of the master. Svakiya veta. Ratrav aniva annehi tajnyata. They rob away either in the night or the day without anybody's knowledge. Both they are stayavaha, stayu. These are called stayu. Stayu means one who wins over the confidence of the master. And say, so one who, that is, robs away either daytime or night without the knowledge of anyone. Stayu nam palakaya nama. The one who protects them. Now one more meaning can be taken. All this tena, chuk, vanchata, vanchaka, parivanchaka, etc. Even if they are thieves, cheats, robbers, if they are devoted to Rudra, he protects them. And if he protects, what will happen? If they have got devotion, in course of time they are bound to get rid of these criminal acts, etc. So that also can be taken. Pati can be taken, palaka, protector, either they as a devotee or otherwise. Also otherwise how he protects? Satta spurti. The very capacity for the thief to function is on account of who? Ishvara. So that way also as such. So one who, those among them who are devotees, he protects. Continue.
Namo Nityarave
Paricharaya Rajnyana Pataye Namaha
Paricharaya Rajnyana Pataye Namaha
Nityarave Namaha Paricharaya Namaha Aranyanam Pataye Namaha. So one is Niheru, one who is in the house of the master, but all the time alert when I am able to steal. One I'll be able to steal. He is there with some size, a servant or whatever it may be. He is the house of the master. But all the time alert to seize the opportunity to steal. He is called Nicheru. Then Paricharaya, the one who always moves where? In the shops, streets, gardens, railway station, like these pickpockets, etc. So this like the pickpockets, etc. So the aap, that is aapana means shop, vithi street, pravatika garden, adav apahara buddhyacharana shila, always moves in such places like railway stations, etc. Banks also, so that so he is in the cashier's queue there to deposit the thing, and this fellow as if also is on and pinches and then goes. So that is it. So with a motive to steal, so Paricharaya Aranyana, so in the forest, those who are travelers in olden days. Even nowadays also. Do you know that? About 5-6 years back, in Mahabaleshwar Ghat, from this side, which side? From Goa highway side, etc. Goa highway side. See, we are going in the car, 2 o'clock. And that Ambivali Ghat, etc. is there, no? There. Because the night means deserted, there is nothing. Some people stopped the car and rocked away. And these fellows, all ornaments were with them. Because that flat is empty here, nobody in the flat here saying, they took along with them. Now there is a board there. Dur Narakshetra. Huh? See, that Ghat, you say that. There is a board put there, means decoys area, etc. Dur Narakshetra. It is after that right turn to, while going to Mahabaleshwar, after that right turn to Pratapgarh, no? What is that Garh? Pratapgarh. Yes, means while coming from this Mahabaleshwar, first this place, after a few furlongs from that left turn to Pratapgarh. So that is what Rabha Rathi. Waiting for an opportunity in such a solitary place. Because daytime what happens, many vehicles come, etc. And the night time, no, they put the stones, etc. And the vehicle has to stop. So that is necessary. So the best stay in the Nishangane. Aranyanam Pataye Navaha. So that is those who stay or who roam in the forest to see a steel, they are called Aranyanam Pataye Navaha. Continue.
Nama Trukari Yodika Vum Sadhya.
Srikavibhyaha nama rudraya namaha. Srik here means vajra, which vajra, not diamond, vajrayudha, what is called as thunderbolt, Indra, thunderbolt. That is, so the one who wields the what vajra, what for? Swashvariram avanti srikavinaha. Srika means vajrayudha. Tena vajrayudhena swashariram avanti. Those who protect one's body, they are called srikavinaha. Rudras who protect their body with thunderbolts, vajrayudha, are called as srikavinaha. Srikavibhyaha namaha. And to those rudras, my namaskara. Jighasantaha means those who want to kill, those who desire to kill. Skanda Bhasha says these are worst murderers. Means not only rob but kills the person. So that is it. Jighasantaha. Jighasantaha means those who kill and rob. So unto them my namaskara. Mushnatam pataye namaha. Mushnantaha means also thieves. What are those? These are farmers. Farmers work for masters and from the field they steal the grains, etc. They steal the grains, etc. So that is, so krishikaha santaha, these farmers, swami dhanyanam apahartaraha. Apahartaraha, those who steal away the swami dhanya, grains of the master, they are pushnantaha, the one who protects them, unto the rudra, my namaskara. Chant together the second tonight, third anuvak, or today third anuvak.
Namah sagamanaya nirvyadinaha vyadininam pataye namo namah kakubhaya nishanjine tenanam pataye namo Yeah. ఆదిత్యస్య ఓ నమో నమ ఆదినేభ్యస్య యానేభ్యస్య ఓ నమో నమః స్వహస్తేభ్యస్య ఓ నమో నమః తిష్ఠస్తేభ్యస్య ఓ నమో నమః సభాభ్యస్తభాపతిభ్యస్య ఓ నమో నమో అశ్వేభ్యో స్వపతిభ్యస్య ఓ నమః ఓం శాంతి 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 ఓం స్వస్తి ప్రజాభ్య పరిపాలయంతా న్యాయేన మార్గేణ మహీమహీషా సో బ్రాహ్మణేభ్య శుభమస్తు నిత్యం లోకా సమస్తా సుఖినో భవంతు కాలే వర్షతు పర్జన్యః పృథివీ తస్య శాలిని దేశోయం శోకరహిత బ్రాహ్మణా సంతు నిర్భయా ఓం సర్వే భవంతు సుఖినః సర్వే సంతు నిరామయా సర్వే భద్రాణి పశ్యంతు మా కశ్చిద్ దుఃఖభాగ్ భవేత్ అసతో మా సద్గమయ తమసో మా జ్యోతిర్గమయ మృత్యో మా అమృతం గమయ ఓం పూర్ణమదః పూర్ణమిదం పూర్ణాత్ పూర్ణముదచ్యతే పూర్ణస్య పూర్ణమాదాయ పూర్ణమేవావశిష్యతే ఓం శాంతి 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 హరి ఓం.